guys and girls, welcome back to the wonderful world of Skyrim. And before we do anything else, I just have to say mistakes were made. Unfortunately, I recorded the next episode and the one after that. That's right, almost 1.5 episodes before I realized that my mic was not turned on. It's actually kind of embarrassing, to be honest, but I have fixed it, I hope. Otherwise, it's gonna be another hour before I figure it out. So that being said, we are here right outside of Whiterun, and we've got some stuff to do. Before we go inside, I want to say what I want to do in there, and there's three main things. One is I want to join the companions, so we're gonna start that quest line. Two, we have our quest from Riverwood, I want to say that's the name, Riverwood with what's his nuts, his uncle, I think it starts with an H, Hadvar, started with an H, did it. We have to go and talk to the Jarl for Hadvar's uncle. I have, in fact, switched my, key binding from Alt to Shift for sprinting, which has been awesome. I kept on pressing Alt or Shift to sprint, and that like slows you down. So like I would keep on like doing this, and then realizing I was doing it wrong, and I was frustrating. And the last thing is I want to. There's a mod that I have installed that's called Practice Dummies that allows us to utilize the Practice Dummies for literally anything before this guy talks to us. And we can level up our skills up to level 30, and we'll do that.
Halt! City's closed with the dragons about. Official business only.
We are gonna just try and persuade him.
Fine. But we'll be keeping an eye on you.
That way we can get a little bit more speechcraft. It's helpful for getting better prices and whatnot. That won't be too much of an issue to get that up, because we're gonna be, eventually we'll go through alchemy, not in this episode obviously, and probably not any time in the next 2 or 3 episodes, to be honest. I mean, probably maybe three episodes, because we're gonna start the companions quest, the Jarl from Whiterun here, they're probably gonna give us, well they will give us a quest. I've played this game before, I know. I don't wanna try not to spoil things, but YOLO. If you haven't played Skyrim, play it. It's a great game. I'll try not to spoil things, but at the same time, it's kind of hard not to if you already know. Alright, but he's going to give us a quest. And then we also have to come back and finish those quests, which is probably going to be 3 episodes. And after that, we might go and do some alchemy stuff. Think about it.
Mister, could you spare a coin? Just one gold. Oh, thank you. Divines, bless your kind heart.
Gives us the gift of charity, which I don't remember what it does, but it's for a gold piece. You get a gift, whatever. Money's pretty easy to come by here. So yeah, like I was saying with the training people, the practice dummies, we can train up our skills, and I'm going to start out with two-handed, which I'm not sure how high we are already, but we just swing at this. Alright, so we're already to level 30 with this. Just go in the old inventory and grab the pickaxe, which is a one-handed weapon. We can start leveling this up. As we swing, increase our one-handed, we might get a level or two, I'm not really sure how much we get. This is a pretty good time to talk about False Scar. I'm not sure if I've talked about it yet, because I've recorded, I don't remember what I've recorded and what I haven't, but False Scar is a mod, basically adds a completely new DLC land, and I want to do that around level 10-ish. But there's a couple of things I want to finish first. One of them is I want to do the main quest until we go to High Hrothgar and finish that a little bit. Which I think is like either two or three quests in. It's like two or three quests from where we are right now. I don't remember which one. But once we're done with that, we'll go ahead and we'll finish up the companions until we get to about level 10 or 12-ish. And I think at that time we'll be strong enough to do some stuff, hopefully. Unfortunately, if we go too far down the companions line, I'd rather just finish it because it gives you certain perks that I'd rather not have. I don't want to spoil it for you, but basically, it's going to give us some perks, I guess you could call them, that I just don't want. Alright, so we're level 30. Let's see how much we've leveled up. I'm going to get my health up to about 150, then work on stamina to about 150, and then we'll get magicka. I have to check. It's either 110 or 120. To cast an Atronach. I don't remember which one, but we'll have to get that up so we can cast an Atronach. Alternatively, there's the some kind of stone that will give us a bonus to Magicka. But I wouldn't mind just having it, so I don't have to use the standing stone for it. But anyways, we're going to do health. We level up twice, which is nice. Okay. Alright. Let us get some armor. Okay. Some two-handed. Give me both of these. Nice. 3% more damage. 2% per level. Okay, that's awesome. Battle axe. Alright, so our halberds count as battle axes. So we're gonna get this one, and I think this entire line is the battle axe line, and that's gonna be the line we'll go down so that we can get basically I want to have my two-handed be the primary one, but with battle axes, halberds. So this is going to be the primary weapon for us, the halberd. Alright, and that perk gave us a little bit of bleeding, which will kill enemies over time. I'm not sure how long it lasts, but it's a decent amount. So while we're here, Nior Vaskar will go and join the companions. Or at least rather start the quest line.
Just keep moving.
I knew it. Wear him out.
Ha! These two are just kind of fighting each other. You know, this is like, if you're familiar with Oblivion or Morrowind, this is like the Fighters Guild of Skyrim.
Pull him back.
Oh, got his ass. Nice.
You think you stand a chance?
All right, let's talk to this guy.
Are you gonna let me watch or not?
A man of my station has many debts. I'm not much use of labor or learning. The companions let me fight for gold.
I want to join the companions.
Yeah.
I don't want to know why you joined. I don't care about that.
Little blood to clear the air.
All right.
You have a stomach for it, outsider.
Can I join?
So you think you have what it takes?
Yep.
Lucky for you, I'm not the one who makes that decision. Talk to Kodlak. Who knows? Maybe he's in a generous mood.
All right.
I'll take my leave then.
So he is going to be downstairs somewhere. So we'll have to go find him. Basically looking for the dude who looks like what's his name, bro? God, I can't remember his name. Oh well, he's got white hair. Oh, there he is.
But I still
a stranger comes to our hall.
I'd like to join the
companions. Would you now? Here. Yes, perhaps. A certain strength of spirit.
Master, you're not truly considering accepting him.
I am nobody's master, Vilkas. And last I checked, we had some empty beds in Yorvaskar for those with a fire burning in their hearts.
Apologies. But perhaps this isn't the time. I've never even heard of this outsider.
Sometimes the famous come to us. Sometimes men and women come to us to seek their fame. It makes no difference. What matters is their heart.
and their arm.
Why do you have?
Of course.
Okay.
How are you in battle, boy?
I can handle myself. I can handle myself.
That may
I can
be
click
so.
On things.
This is Vilkas. Of course. Vilkas, take him out to the yard and see what he can do.
That's one of the things I think I mentioned in the first episode. Is the UI is made for consoles, so sometimes I'll click on stuff and it just won't work. Alright, so he's gonna want to take us outside.
If you wish to hunt him, Isgrimore himself
might as well just
meet
him
the
outside.
To deal with all the rabble around here.
The old man said to have a look at you, so let's do this. Mm-hmm. Just have a few swings at me so I can see your form. Don't worry, I can take it.
Looks slow to me.
There you go.
Not bad. Next time won't be so easy. You might just make it, but for now. Here's my sword. Mm-hmm. Go take it up to Yorland and have it sharpened.
You bitch now.
And be careful. It's probably worth more than you are.
It's okay. Why don't you go wipe that blood off you? I'll pretend like it didn't happen, jackass. Alright, so basically just gotta go on some little... Go fetch me this, go send people to this quests. But we are just an initiate still. We're not even... I don't even know for that.
What brings you here? I'm guessing you're the newcomer then. Oh, don't worry too much about it. They were all whelps once. They just might not like to talk about it. And don't always just do what you're told. Nobody rules anybody in the companions.
All right, good talking to you. Well,
I'm not sure how they've managed it, but they have. Kodlak is the harbinger, and he's a sort of advisor for the whole group. But every man is his own. Every woman, her own.
Okay. Well, I need to get...
I have a favor to ask. I've been working on a... My wife is in mourning, and I need to get back to her soon. I'd be much obliged if you could take this to Aella for me.
Yep.
That's a good man.
Alright. Let's take the shield down. I actually kind of like him. He's just kind of a smith doing his work. Good at what he does. And the Sky Forge allows us to forge a few unique items. Not that they're very good, if I remember right, but they are unique, so.
My brother Vilkas is a better talker than me. He should be around someplace.
Wait. Oh, that's our quest marker. Not the quest marker, it's our just regular marker that we placed for, I think, the standing stones. Alright, where is the journal? Set that as our active quest. She's over here.
If you wish to hunt with me. Ah, good, I've been waiting for this. Are you new here?
I am.
I told you. This is the whelp that Vilkas mentioned.
Ah, yes. I heard you gave him quite a thrashing.
Don't let Vilkas catch you saying that.
Do you think you could handle Vilkas in a real fight?
Probably not.
Here, let's have Farkas show you where you'll be resting your head.
Okay.
Farkas. Did you call me?
Of course we did, Ice Brain.
You are
show this
nice.
New blood where the rest of the whelps sleep.
New blood?
It's fine.
Oh, hello. I'm Farkas. Come, follow me.
Okay. Just trying to see if any of these are worth reading.
Skior and Aella like to tease me, but they're good people.
Come on,
they challenge us to be our best.
Yep. Keep walking, please.
Isgrimore himself wouldn't have the patience to deal with all the rabble around here.
Nice to have a new face around. It gets boring here sometimes.
I'm sure.
I hope we keep you. This can be a rough life.
Yep.
The quarters are up here. Just pick a bed and fall in it when you're tired. Thelma will keep the place clean. She always has.
Okay.
All right, so here you are. Looks like the others are eager to meet you. Come to me or Aella if you're looking for
what
work.
The?
Yes. Once you've made a bit of a name for yourself, Skior and Vilkas might have things for you to do.
Sounds good.
Good luck. Welcome to the Companions.
Shanks.
By the way, there's some trouble in Eastmarch. Farmers getting troubled by some bad types who built up a stronghold in the air. Nothing but a bunch of lonely bandits.
Okey-doke.
I knew you could be counted on. Do what must be done.
That I can do, comrade. Alright, so it's just a quest that they're gonna send us on. I think we have to do like one or two of them before we actually get to do anything of substance with the Companions. We'll do that when we go out for the quest with the Jarl. Can I jump, please? Can I jump, please? Thank you. Alright. Dragon's Reach. Alright. I don't know if I screwed up something, but for some reason I wasn't able to get any of the mods to work with multiple companions, so even though I tried, Dreadborn here is probably going to be the only companion we have for a while.
What would you have
What's
me do
the
then?
Meaning of this interruption? Nothing. Jarl Balgrup is not
please.
Receiving visitors.
This is no time
okay.
For rash action.
Well,
I just think
that
we
explains
need
why the guards let you in. Come on, then. The Jarl will want to speak to you personally.
Who's this, then?
Well, my name
so
is...
So, you were at Helgen. You saw this dragon with your own eyes?
Yes, because I wasn't there for that. That was not what I know.
Smear Ireleth was right. What do you say now, Proventus? Shall we continue to trust in the strength of our walls?
Probably
against
not.
Against the dragon?
My lord, we should send troops to Riverwood at once. It's in the most immediate danger if that dragon is lurking in the mountains.
The Jarl of Falkreath will view that
rolls?
As a provocation. He'll assume we're preparing to join Ulfric's
yes,
side
please.
And attack him.
We should not...
I'll not stand idly by while a dragon burns my hold and slaughters my people.
Damn right.
Ireleth, send a detachment to Riverwood at once.
Good work.
Yes, my Jarl.
If you'll excuse me, I'll return to my duties.
That would be best, Jackass.
That would be best.
You missed
well
the Jackass
done.
Part.
You sought me out on your own initiative. You've done Whiterun a service. I won't
no,
forget
I,
it.
Here, on my own.
Take this as
yeah,
a small token
here,
of my esteem.
Nice.
That is another thing you... Come, let's go find Faringar, my court wizard. He's been looking into a matter related to these dragons and rumors of dragons.
Right. Let's see if you got any decent books. The more I read... better off we can get
Faringar. I think I've found someone who can help you with your dragon project. Go ahead and fill him in with all the details.
Take your time, boss. Oh, where are you going? There you are.
So the Jarl thinks you can be of use to me. Oh yes, he must. Yes, I could use. Well, when I say fetch, I really mean delve into a dangerous
That's
ruin
exactly
in search
what
of an
everyone
ancient
in Skyrim
stone tablet
means when they
that
say,
may
grab
or may not actually
something.
Be there.
Well, it's going to be there, otherwise it wouldn't be a quest. I mean, this is Skyrim, after all.
Straight to the point, eh? No need for tedious hows and whys. I like that. Leave those details to your betters, am I right?
Well,
I
better
learned
than you,
of a certain
so.
Stone tablet said to be housed in Bleak Falls Barrow. Dragon stone said to contain... Go to Bleak Falls Barrow. Find this tablet, no doubt interred in the main chamber, and bring it to me. Simplicity itself.
I'm not sure if you're being sarcastic about the way Bethesda makes them.
You should join
anything
the
we can use to fight this dragon or dragons. We need it quickly, before it's too late.
Of course, Jarl Balgruuf. You seem to have found me an able assistant. I'm sure he will prove most useful.
I'll kill you.
Succeed at this, and you'll be rewarded.
Yeah, so I kind of like how they seem to poke fun a little bit at themselves there. How they usually do their quests. No doubt in the main chamber. Oh, can I not? Alright. Let's go to the map. Travel on Skyrim. Bleak Falls. Turn off that one. So, one of these quests, we have to go to Bleak Falls Barrow. And the other one, we're going up here to the Winter War. I think that what we're going to do first is we'll go to Bleak Falls. And what I'm going to do is go to Riverwood first. I'm going to take off our hat. And then we'll go up to Bleak Falls. We'll go through Bleak Falls this episode. Next episode, we'll go up to the Winter War. And maybe make it back to Dragon's Reach then. So, let's go on over. First couple times I played Skyrim, I didn't realize that if you go to Riverwood first, there's actually a path that leads up. So I would walk literally from Whiterun up these mountains and try and like scale the mountains or whatever to get to Bleak Falls. And it was a struggle, to be quite honest. Alright. One thing I do want to do, as long as I can take these things, I want to check to make sure I can't upgrade anything while I'm here. Alright, so this... Oh, that's right, he gave us that steel armor. But I want to see if I can't make a lantern. Sort of buckles. Alright. And then... Do we have anything for... leather? That just kicked me out. Another problem with the UI. Classic. Leather. So we might start making some of these guys because we can. They increase carrying capacity, but that's gonna be later on. All right. So I think we need leather strips. So let's use the wolf pelt to make one leather, and we'll make some leather strips. I think that's all we need for the lantern. Alright. So travel. Perfect. Alright. So now we've got another travel lantern which we can get.
Let's get
him.
Going. Let's what do you need to take?
Alright, I want to give you a travel lantern. Where is my... There it is. Alright, so R to give. Okay.
Lead on.
So I think I gave him the one that I was wearing. Oh no, I didn't. Then. There we go. He should have his lantern. Let's see, does he turn it on, maybe? Maybe once we go into a dungeon. But that way we both have some, give us a little bit better lighting. Alright. Actually, his head bar out here. I want to see if we can't buy some weapons. Or maybe sell everything he has back to him. That might be worth it. Alright, I think I'm just going to wait here until morning. So we'll wait about 7 hours. I think it's 8 o'clock when shops open, so if you wait until about 9-ish, you will basically guaranteed to have the shops be open. There he is.
Hi.
Alivor.
Gert, she and Hod run the mill. I see no... The grinds, if you've got the raw materials...
Can I not buy things from
you?
You
can use the forge to make something new.
Strangers here. I'm spoken for, you know, so don't get any ideas.
Okay, can I...
Yes?
Hi. Not buy things from you? That's unfortunate. Let's see if I can't... See what weapons... The old Riverwood trader has.
Well, one of us has to do something.
I said no. No adventures, no theatrics, no thief chasing.
They're arguing.
Well, what are you going to do then, huh? Let's hear it.
What do you think we do?
We are done talking about this. Oh.
Oh. Yep. Sorry. Yep. Yeah, I'm a
sorry
customer.
You had
yep.
to hear that.
All right.
Well, I don't know what you overheard, but the Riverwood trader is
Oh, a bit of this and a bit of that.
Yeah, I realize that. Alright, so some iron stuff. Steel glaive. Kinda cool. But we have our halberd already. As you can see, it's not all that expensive. I mean, we got plenty of monies. I do want to sell him some of that stuff we picked up. Try and get the monies. We'll go through that. And some food. I don't really use food all that much. Alright, books, miscellaneous. The hide isn't even worth anything. Ingots can be worth stuff. Unless we're starting to run low on weight, I'm not really gonna sell those.
I better get back to cleaning the store. What a mess.
So basically they lost a claw. Well, I guess we can talk to him.
The Riverwood trait. We did have a bit of an ornament. Solid gold. You could? I've got some coin coming in from my last shipment. It's yours if you bring my claw back.
Yep.
Now, if you're going to get those thieves, you should head to Bleak Falls Barrow, northwest of town.
So this is your plan, Lucan?
So basically we're going exactly where we were going to go, up to Bleak Falls.
We got some firs and tree branches, paint them white, and then tie them to stump. Instant frostbite.
All right, so let's swim over. Try and harvest some of the stuffs in and around the area. Just want to start to get in the habit of quick saving a little bit more. Just in case something does end up killing me. We'll have quick saves closer to where we need to be. And seeing as we did do a decent amount of stuff so far, I'd rather not have to restart and do it again for like the third time. That would be frustrating. Even more frustrating than it already is, but it's fine. I don't think we've leveled up. No. Okay. I believe that this game, if you level up, it will automatically restore all of your health and stuff. So that's one thing that you can save for the middle of combat, ironically, is to level up and restore all your health. And it saves you from having to buy another health potion and whatnot. So I'm going to try and do this all stealthily. It's not going to work very well, I tell you. But who needs stealth when he can just chop people's heads off, am I right? Alright.
Looky here, looks like we got ourselves.
Unlike Fallout 4, this one still uses the old system where it pauses the game while you loot. So you can abuse that a little bit. Decapitation. We should, as we level up our two-handed skill, we should unlock more and more kill moves. But for right now, we only have a limited set of kill moves, so we're not going to get a whole lot of them. Nice little cache there. I guess we could have picked up a lantern here, but oh well. Increased our crafting a slight bit by doing it that way. Looks like there's some iron down there. We'll do that some other time. I'm thinking about installing the mod that makes ore veins like light up so they're easier to spot, but I also might not. I don't know. There's still a couple of mods that I could install that aren't on the little mod page that Bethesda's made for this game, that I'm pretty sure are on the Nexus, which is where I usually get the mods from. I might consider. We want to stealth this a little bit. I don't plan on stealthing a whole lot because I'm not trying to do a stealthy character, but it does help us level up faster if we just walk up with a bit of stealth. If we go hidden, that should increase stealth. Okay, we're gonna be found. Got him. Alright, there should be one more. So I'll loot these guys before we can move, before I forget about them. And, where's the last one? Over here. Alright.
Do your work!
I didn't even die in 2 hits. I wonder if it changed my difficulty. Alright, so one thing I did notice is that my difficulty was way too low. I think it was set on normal. And I was just killing everything in one hit. Alright, so I think Master... Yeah, so I like to have a one below Legendary, because Legendary, I think they get, like, silly buffs and we get silly nerfs. And it just... You end up swinging 1,000 times to kill one dragon, and it's just not all that fun. I find that the Master difficulty, which is like one below, it's a good mix if you can kill lower tiered stuff or lower leveled stuff pretty easily, but at the same time, the higher level stuff is difficult enough where you actually need some, you should need a little bit of work to kill them, which is kind of nice. It's a good balance. Alright, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to save, and then we'll continue down into Bleak Falls Barrow, but I want to save here before anything too crazy happens. Alright, so let's go into Bleak Falls Barrow. We'll continue to sneak to just try and level this skill up a little bit. Unlike when they were outside, we are basically going to have a little bit better of a time just because they're facing the other way. I don't really need to do this stealthily, so I'm not going to try and, like, go crazy with it. So, been spotted. Mr. Pretty shittily. Got his ass. Weird, I don't think she hit me. Alright, we gotta level up. I think we'll save this maybe for the, one of the bosses in here. I think there's two of them. One like half boss, half it's gonna become a normal enemy later, and the other one's like a legitimate boss. But regardless, we've got some stuff to get here. Unfortunately, weapons weigh way too much, and they're not worth picking up for the most part. It's kind of cool. 18 damage. What's this one? 9. Holy shit. Ridiculous. It's like twice as much as the other one. Oh, there's a gap here. I wonder how many times I've missed him in all the playthroughs. I don't think I've ever looted him before. But the skeever tails are kind of useful. They're alchemy ingredients. We can use them for that when we finally get to it. Alright, empty. I want to look around for all the treasure and stuff that we can find, because the more stuff you find, the more money you can get, the more stuff you can buy, and the better off you'll be, basically, is my mantra, my idea of this. If you want to just blow through it, I mean, it's not really how I like to play things. I'd much rather do things kind of slow and steady and get through it that way. Level on up a little bit. Alright. So basically what that's intended to show is that if you pull this lever, we're gonna get shot by a bunch of darts. You can see these little holes here, those are the dart shooters. And they might have some on the sides too, but I'm not really sure. Basically, we have to figure out the dark sword. Holy shit. These guys, I mean, this is really cool. If I was doing like a vampire playthrough, that would be a totally badass sword to have. That's like really powerful. 18 damage. I think this two-handed weapon, which probably swings half as fast as that thing would, does... Well, I guess that's kind of fair, but this thing's also been improved a little bit, too, so... Let's loot this before we do it. So basically, to solve most of these puzzles, we're just gonna look. So the face has got a snake, fish thing, and obviously that face right there is on the ground, so let's go snake, fish. So, snake, fish... is a snake, fish, and since there's only three of them, it should be snake, fish. Pull the lever. Alright. So now, having played this, I know that there's a bunch of fucking skeevers. I almost said Skaven. I'm playing too much Total War Warhammer. Well, not even that. Call of Warhammer. I just finished off the Skaven in the area. Yesterday, well, last night, I guess, really is the way to say that in English. Banded iron armor is 37. 43, it's not worth it. Alright. Always nice to increase our stats. Oh, fuck. I missed one. Thanks, boss. Alright. Looted all of them now. Alright. You do regenerate health over time, so unless you're in the middle of a battle, health potions really don't help a whole lot. But if we need to, I do have the regeneration.
Is someone coming? Is that you, Hotnir? Bjorn!
That jackass. That, some chest, get those, actually I got steel gauntlets on right now. Alright, so I'm going to quick save right here. This is the first little mini boss.
Keep it away from me, I'll have your head.
Mostly thanks to you, we took that guy out. It's usually how you deal with him because he can't fit through this doorway. If you just kind of stand in it and then back up as he comes, it's a pretty easy way to kite him. Alright, turn. Alright, I'm just gonna kill this guy because otherwise he.
You, over here! It's coming loose! I can.
Otherwise, he just tries to run away. But. I still have to loot this area, so let's get through. Alright. That says empty on it. I probably should have read that first. Alright, did we get this? Yes, we did. I should really read the empty signs before I just automatically assume there's stuff in it. Stuff out of here. I don't know what mod it is, but there's a mod I've had installed in the past. Every single time you open up one of these little egg sacks, it spawns like 30 spiders around you. It's really annoying. I'm not sure what mod that was, but I hated it. Alright, so this is the claw we have to return to Arvanichi, or whatever the hell his name is, from the Riverwood Trader. This is the journal. case you're ever stuck. Usually Bethesda likes to put in a tutorial on how to do everything. So that journal basically will tell you how to complete the next puzzle we will face. In case you ever get stuck wondering how to do these things, usually they've got a pretty simple, hey dumbass, here's how you do it, type deal built into the game. It's not always obvious what it is, but sometimes they do. Not gonna lie, the first time I ever did this, I spent a good long, I literally, I'll show it to you, but
keep your eyes open.
I was not the brightest person to do it the way I did it. I mean, it worked. It just took fucking forever, and I ended up just cheating and going on the internet for the second one. Alright. Killed us some nice Draugr. I think they're all done. Skeletons here aren't able to be looted, but the dead Draugr are. So go through and steal their 3 gold. Okay. So now this trap, which is right there, doesn't really point very well, but that thingy, this guy, I know damn well, is gonna set it off, so I gotta run through it. Oh wow, he didn't set it off. Proud of him. Alright, so let's go take this guy out. Alright. The bleeding damage does a really good job of taking out stuff that with the heavy armor, where my main attack won't necessarily get through, that bleeding damage just destroys them. That trap next, if I want to finish looting this area. It's empty. Okay, there's a chest up here. Jump, please. Guys, for what we need. So, damn it. Thought I had made it past. Alright, unfortunately, a friend decided to run in behind us and got slashed. So, if you can get to these guys before they draw their weapon. They're pretty easy to kill. Alright, let's see if we can't level up our archery a little bit. Alright, R is to sheath. Alright. Good work. it right here. Do my quick save. Getting close to the final chamber. Never mind, I lied. We still got a little bit of ways to go. Thing is, these draugr are still pretty leveled down, just because we aren't a super high level yet. So they're just—they're not good draugr. They're the shitty ones without much armor. Until we get to a higher level, that's really most of what we're gonna be facing are those unarmored ones. But pretty fucking quick. It's also like the main beginner dungeon. This is like designed for beginner characters. It's not very difficult to complete this dungeon. It's just kind of long. Not to say other dungeons in this game aren't long. There are definitely lots of nice long dungeons. Like, thinking of the giant dwarven city that just spans like half the underworld, or half the map underneath the ground. I forget its name, but that one's just fucking huge. Alright, good. Alright, let's go down here. Got a skiva. Perfect. It's always nice when you get it on the first try. Where's the exit? So I want to get as much alchemy stuff as we can. So here's the Restless Draugr. These guys are a little bit better armored. You can see they take much more hits. I accidentally hit our friend. Alright. Those guys are gonna become basically the norm here. Not too fast. Pretty fast is what I meant to say. Motherfucker. This thing's gonna give me like 3 gold too. Watch it. Three lockpicks down. Alright, so we got a little bit of stuff. I'm finding a lot of that banded armor. Interesting. Alright, now we're starting to get close. I think we've got like one or two more mini passageways and then we're there. Again. Okay. Three perks. I've got the maximum level of that. Can't get anything else here. This one will give us more two-handed. Alright. And then I want to get maybe some more heavy armor stuff. Alright. We got one more perk. Let's put it into alchemy. So we want to start to work on that here. Near future. You guys see our health level, health went back to 100%. Alright, we'll finish looting this after everybody's dead.
Oh my god.
always nice to level up combat skills. One thing I do actually want to do quick, maybe we'll do it next episode before we go to the Winter War place. I think what we'll do is we'll go to the Lover's Stone. And the standing stones we've got right now will give us a 20% increase, but only gives us to the combat skills. So one-handed, two-handed archery, and I think that's it. We go to the Lover's Stone, literally anything we do, we've got a 15% increase. So we don't get quite as much, but it's for everything. So sneak, alchemy, basically anything we do, we get a 15% increase, and that's just... it's so superior that it's just not worth doing anything else. But we're so early in the game that it's not really needed. It's really more for the higher tiers once we start to really have to focus on what we're doing to actually level up. Alright, so here. So what I was talking about earlier is if you spin these, right, they spin. And in order to figure it out, you have to activate the keyhole. Right. If it doesn't work, it just doesn't work. So I literally would spin one, work, spin one, work, and I went through all of them. I got so frustrated because I couldn't figure out how to do it. And how you do these with the claws is you go to the claw. I'm playing on PC. You just use your scroll, click on it, and then you use your scroll wheel to look at it, and you can see this is a bear, moth, owl, and that's what we have to put in. And I had to go online to figure that out, and there's a shit ton of these claws. There's like at least four or five, and each one opens up a different one of these puzzles, and I couldn't figure it out. So it was bear, moth, owl. We got the bear, we need the moth, we need the owl. All right, we activate it. Now, this is the inner sanctum. Let's get a quick save again. Some bets. Last time I came in here, I spent a really long time looking, because they've got extra chests. Almost guaranteed, Bethesda will put in a special little secret chest in all these areas. And the one here, it's right here. So we got steel warhammer, which is pretty nice, but we don't need it. It's 25. We could grab it, but I 25 pounds. There's so many better things we can put in our inventory than that. So we'll get to the word wall in a second. Alright. Just gonna pick up everything we can, because there's gonna be a dude who comes out of this. After we go over here. Hallelujah. Alright. So, we've learned our first word. I want to kill this guy as fast as we can before he hopefully swings at us. Alright. Thank God. Oh. I died to this guy the last time I came in here because I forgot that he spawned and I was talking about what words were and I got fucking slashed in the back of the head and he killed me. This is worth it because it's got an enchantment on it, and we can disenchant it to get the enchantment. Alright. So it's going to tell us to go back to Whiterun now. I don't want to do that, obviously. Because that'd just be a waste of time. So, conveniently, we have an exit over here. And we can exit out. There is nothing up there, so let's take these flowers, and I guess we can keep the skull for now. It'll be one of the first things we drop if we go overboard on weight. Yeah, if the Daedric armor wasn't what's it called, where it's not symmetrical, unsymmetrical, dissymmetrical maybe. If it wasn't non-symmetrical, I would totally wear it, but it is, and it's really frustrating to me. I can't look at it, but it's good armor, but I can't use it because it's not symmetrical, it doesn't look right. Alright, so, in the next episode, cleared Bleak Falls Barrow, and we'll go back to Dragon's Reach eventually, but in the next episode, I'm going to go to the Lover's Stone, which I think is right over in these mountains up here. We'll do that quick, and then we'll head over to Winterhold, or Winterhelm, and go to the Winter War. And there's a bunch of farms over here that have got some good sources of wheat and snowberries and chicken eggs, and I really wouldn't mind having those, so we will stop there. But yeah, so I will see you guys in the next episode where we head over to the Lover's Stone and do that stuff. So make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and I will catch you guys in a little bit.